Hi everyone. Today we will discuss how IntelliJ IDEA can help you write Scala-free code with indentation-based syntax. This alternative to curly braces has been with us for a couple of years already, and since Scala 3.3, we also have the optional fewer braces feature, which allows us to use indentation instead of braces in even more situations. However, this approach comes with a few quirks too. So this video will be about how parsing indentation-based code works, partly about how we support it, and also partly about how you can, broadly speaking, control indentation in IntelliJ IDEA. First, let's create a new product. For simplicity, I will call it indentation. As you can see, I'm using Scala 3.3.5, so in addition to the standard indentation-based syntax, we will also have access to the fewer braces optional syntax. I marked the sample code checkbox, so the new project will already have a simple main method. The new main method looks like it's already written in indentation-based syntax, but that's not actually the case. There's only one statement here, the print line, so this code looks the same in both syntaxes. To turn on the support for indentation-based syntax, we need to go to Settings, Editor, Code Style, Scala, and choose the Other tab. Here, we have a checkbox that says Use indentation-based syntax. Since the 2025.1 release, when you create a new project in Scala 3, this checkbox is unmarked by default. We made this decision on the basis of feedback from developers migrating their projects from Scala 2 to 3, who complained that indentation-based syntax being enabled by default meant that IntelliJ IDEA displayed many unhelpful warning messages. Now, let's create a new enum to use as the basis for our demonstration. We will call it superpower level. In IntelliJ IDEA 2024.2 and earlier, file templates for enums, just like file templates for classes, traits, and so on, contained opening curly braces. Since the new release, the used template depends on the use indentation-based syntax setting. If it's marked, you will see only the name of the new element and the caret at the end of it, so you can type a parenthesis for the primary constructor or a colon to start coding in indentation-based syntax. So let's type a colon and provide four superpower levels: weak, medium, strong, and Hulk. And let's create one more element, this time a case class. We will call it superhero, and it will have a name of the type string and a level of the type superhero level. Now I can open the pop-up menu and choose the put parameters on the separate lines option. IntelliJ IDEA will even show me a preview. Let's go back to the main file. We can now quickly create our first superhero, Iron Man, with the level medium and print him out. Please bear with me while I set this up. I'm doing all this because the support for indentation-based syntax isn't really something I can show on empty files. I need something to work on. Now, we will write a level up method to take a superhero and return a new superhero with a modified name and a superpower level one higher than its previous level. To do this, we write val new level equals hero.level m, and from the pop-up menu, we then choose match exhaustive. In one of the previous videos, we discussed how IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin can generate an exhaustive match case for enums because we already know all possible enum values. On top of that, here you can see how that match case looks when the support for indentation-based syntax is turned on. There are no braces, but each case is indented. Let's now import the enum values for better readability and implement the bump. Now, if I hit enter, IntelliJ IDEA will put the cursor on the same indentation level as the last case. I need to use Shift plus Tab to go left, and once there, I can create a new instance of the superhero case class. If you are used to indentation-based syntax, it might not look so bad, but for me it's a bit difficult to read when there's only a one tab difference between those two lines. One way to distinguish between them more easily is to turn on indentation guides. You can do this via Settings, Editor, General, Appearance. But if you don't want the guides to be visible in the editor all the time, you can instead go to Settings, Languages and Frameworks, Scala, X-ray Mode, and ensure they are marked there. In that case, intent guides will only appear when you are using X-ray Mode. We have a whole article about how X-ray Mode works, and a video as well. You can find the links in the description under this video. Another way to make the code more readable is to use the AND keyword. As you can see, IntelliJ IDEA suggests using the new level name as a marker to make it easier to spot the end of a block of code marked by the AND keyword. We can do the same with the LevelUp method. Again, if I write AND here, IntelliJ IDEA will suggest using the method's name as the marker. Let's say we want to make leveling up more complicated. In the current version, if the superhero reaches the Hulk level, they stay at the Hulk level. But let's imagine a case where a hero at the Hulk level loses their powers. For example, when the Hulk transforms back into Bruce Banner, then we'd want them to become weak again. Let's do this just for the real Hulk, that is, if the name of the hero is the Hulk, then he gets downgraded to the weak level. The comic book logic here isn't particularly important. In this case, it's just an excuse to show how IntelliJ IDEA can help you write readable code. You can see how IntelliJ IDEA properly indented the code block between then and else. When I pressed enter after else, it recognized that the else keyword belonged to the if clause and moved it back. The same happens with other Scala control clauses like for yield or while do. But of course, this code looks very ugly now. Fortunately, IntelliJ IDEA can help us fix it in several ways. We can delete that empty line, select the whole match case, and press Tab to move the selection right, or Shift plus Tab to move the selection left. But this moves all the lines to the same number of tabs. Instead, we can press Ctrl plus Option plus I and let IntelliJ IDEA figure out the indentation. On top of that, instead of selecting the code block with the cursor, we can use Option plus Up. Every time I press Option plus Up, the selection grows to cover one additional level of scope, from a field to a line to the whole match case or if else and so on. To shrink the selection back, I can use Option plus Down. This combines neatly with Ctrl Option I because I can select precisely the block of code with messy indentation and tell IntelliJ IDEA to fix it. Another way to select a block of code is to toggle on sticky selection. I have it under Shift plus Ctrl plus Z, but it's a custom shortcut. You can go to Settings, Key Map, search for sticky selection, and set a shortcut for yourself. Now you will be able to move the carrot with the arrow keys, and the selection will follow. You can turn it off by using the same shortcut again. Another thing we can do is line up the case arrows. This is a non-standard way to beautify the code, but I do it practically everywhere. It helps a lot with readability. To do this, we will clone the carrot. Start by putting the carrot on the weak case line before the arrow, then press Shift plus Option and click on the corresponding place in the Hulk case. You will then have two carrots. We can now use them to write the same code on different lines, like this, but here I will only press Tab, so now the case arrows are all lined up. And if I press Option, I can move many lines of code up and down at the same time by pressing up or down arrow. If you click again anywhere in the editor, the cloned carrot will disappear. Oh, and about pressing Option to move lines of code up and down, there's an even nastier version of this trick. I can press Shift plus Command and use the up and down arrows to move the whole block of code. So, if my carrot is at one of the cases, it will move only the line with the case, but if I put the carrot at the line with the match keyword, I can move the whole match case. And if I put the carrot in a line with if, I can move the whole if-else block. All those little tricks are, of course, also available to you if you're using braces-based syntax, but they become even more helpful if you migrate to indentation-based syntax, because when you do, all of a sudden, lining up your code becomes so much more important. Try them out on a reasonably complex piece of Scala code and see for yourself how useful they can be. Instead of indenting your code manually while you write it, you can also take advantage of IntelliJ IDEA's robust code formatting features. To do so, go back to Settings, Editor, Code Style, Scala. When we were here earlier, we opened the Other tab and marked the checkbox to enable indentation-based syntax. This time, we will discuss the contents of two other tabs, Tabs and Indents, and Wrapping and Braces. On the left, you have various controls to choose from, and on the right, there is example code formatted according to your choices. Those hardly visible gray dots signify empty spaces in the code, and the more pronounced gray lines signify tabs. Until now, I wrote the code using tabs for indentation. Now, let's change it to two white spaces per tab. You can also see that we also have the option to mark the Smart Tabs checkbox, which will allow IntelliJ IDEA to use tabs for regular indentation and white spaces for precise alignment, as I demonstrated earlier with case arrows. But let's keep it unmarked. I switch to white spaces and click OK. Nothing has changed in the code yet, it is still indented with tabs, but in the bottom right hand corner you can now see a small notification named tab. It appeared because IntelliJ IDEA detected that the file in the editor is indented differently from how the settings suggest it should be. If I click on it and select Reindent file with two spaces, IntelliJ IDEA will rewrite the code with two white spaces per tab. On the Tabs and Indents tab, you can also change the number of white spaces used to replace one tab indent, but in Scala, using two white spaces per tab in every situation is common, so I will leave it like this. On the Wrapping and Braces tab, you will find many more options for controlling indentation, braces, and alignment. For the topic of this video, the most important thing to do here might be to make sure that fourth braces options are not marked. You may also look into how if-else is treated. For example, you can decide whether else-if statements are always put in the same line. Finally, you may want to look into how the indent arguments with colons feature works, as this is important if, in addition to indentation-based syntax, you also want to use the fewer braces feature, which has been available since Scala 3.3. Let's change the level up method again. Let's imagine that this time, if the hero is already at the Hulk level, but they are not the actual Hulk, leveling up will kill them. So the method will now return an option of superhero. The new level type will be an option of superpower level, and then we will map it to the superhero constructor. In the end, we will print out the superhero only if they are still alive. So we have the map and forage methods here, and they can both be turned into the fewer braces versions. For now, the support for the fewer braces feature in IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin is pretty basic, but at least the syntax is recognized. IntelliJ IDEA will highlight an error if, for example, you forgot to use proper indentation, or if you put the transformation on the same line as the method call, which requires braces. And one last thing. The Scala 3 compiler supports the no indent option, which turns off indentation-based syntax. In the moment I record this video, IntelliJ IDEA's support for indentation is independent of this option, meaning that, for example, your choice to mark the use indentation-based syntax checkbox does not add the no indent option to the compiler, and conversely, adding the no indent option does not automatically mark the checkbox. But we do recognize that the option is being used. If I add it to build SBT and sync SBT changes, IntelliJ IDEA will now treat the lack of braces in my code as errors. This can be confusing though, so in the future, the way we support no indent will change. Look to release notes to learn more. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. To learn more about what IntelliJ IDEA can do for you, look for more videos on our channel, like and subscribe, read our blog, or chat with the development team on our Discord server. All links can be found in the description. Happy developing!